Good morning, and welcome to St. Mary's. Today's Mass celebrates the 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and our celebrant this morning will be Father Hines. We ask that you please turn off all cell phones and any electronic devices during the Mass, and please join us in our opening hymn, number 648, Save Us, O Lord, number 648.
Save us, O Lord, carry us back, rouse your power and come. Rescue your people, show us your face, bring us back. O Shepherd of Israel, hear us, return and we shall be saved. Arise, O Lord, hear our cries, O Lord, bring us back.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The wicked say, let us beset the just one, because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doings, reproaches us for transgressions of the law, and charges us with violations of our training. Let us see whether his words be true. Let us find out what will happen to him. For if the just one be the Son of God, God will defend him and deliver him from the hand of his foes. With revilement and torture, let us put the just one to the test, that we may have proof of his gentleness and try his patience. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to his own words, God will take care of him. The word of the Lord.
The Lord upholds my life. The Lord upholds my life. O God, by your to the words of my mouth. The Lord upholds my life. For the haughty have risen up against me. The ruthless seek my life. They have set not God before their eyes. The Lord upholds my life. Behold, God is my helper. The Lord sustains my life. Freely sacrifice. I will praise your name, O Lord, for its goodness. The Lord upholds my life.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder in every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure, then peaceable, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. Where do wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet, but do not possess. You kill and envy, but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask, but do not receive because you ask wrongly to spend it on your passions. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus and his disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee, but he did not wish anyone to know about it. He was teaching his disciples and telling them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill him. And 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise." But they did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to question him. They came to Capernaum, and once inside the house, he began to ask them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they remained silent. They had been discussing among themselves on the way who was the greatest. Then he sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be the last of all and servant of all." Taking a child, he placed it in their midst, and putting his arms around it, he said to them, "Whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me. And whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Yesterday, I had the great pleasure of celebrating the wedding of my cousin. And the evening before, there was a slideshow of the groom and the bride as they grew up, and then the pictures began to merge as their lives joined together. There, in many of those pictures, you would see either the bride as they were dating looking lovingly upon her husband, or the groom looking lovingly upon his future bride. This is a desire of every human heart, and it speaks to who we are as human beings. The look of love. All of you, at some point, have experienced it. Whether it is the look of your spouse, or husband and wife, whether it is the look of a parent to a child, or even a child looking back at his or her parents. And the very basic need of the human heart is to be seen and to see. This is why I think our Lord privileges children here in the Gospel of Mark, and also elsewhere in the next chapter, which we'll hear in a few weeks on Sunday. We must be like little children, for in fact, even as the years grow older, or we grow older, we remain at heart little children. But as the years come, they don't come by themselves, and little by little, we pick up things that we make it difficult for us to release, to be that child still. There's a beautiful story that is recounted in the Catechism of the Catholic Church from the life of the Cure d'Ars. When St. John Marie Vianney arrived at his parish, he would often notice at the back of the church, there's a farmer. He would come, he would kneel, and he would just stay there in silence. He wouldn't thumb his rosary beads, he wouldn't pick up a book of the Psalms or any other kind of devotion. He would just kneel and look at the tabernacle. And so as he did this week in and week out, St. John Marie Vianney wondered what he was doing. And so he asked him, he said, "What do you do as you kneel there and look at the tabernacle?" And the humble farmer just simply said, "I look at him and he looks at me." How much does this speak of the desire of the human heart that desires to be seen? Human love mirrors this kind of desire, but it is never sufficient. For no love, no human love, can satisfy the infinite longings of the human heart. Our Lord privileges children because children desire to be looked at and loved precisely in this way. And so he reminds us here in this gospel that when we seek, as the apostles did, to be seen in ways that are not appropriate, when we seek to set ourselves above others, we argue who is the greatest among us, what in fact we are doing is we are trying to say, "Look at me." Parents know this very well, when you, especially with young children, "Look at me, look at me, look at me, look at me. Watch me jump off the diving board into the pool. Watch me ride my bike." That desire never goes away, but it is hidden at times. And so one of the chores of the life of a Christian is to discover that little child within and to recognize that we too need to be seen as well. Just as that farmer would go to the back of the church and he would look at the tabernacle, we too can do no better than to follow his example. So when we come to church, we can look lovingly upon the tabernacle and receive that love in return. In this way, we will begin to put off those accretions that have grown up around us over the years and once again put on the life of the child within. And then truly, we will know we are loved, for we will see and be seen by the Lord. Let us now stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven.
And by the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate from the Virgin Mary, and became man.
For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who, with the Father and the Son, is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With great confidence, we lift our petitions to the Lord.
For all of the baptized in the church, may God strengthen us in proclaiming the kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who mourn the loss of a loved one, may God's enduring love and mercy and the gift of faith bring them consolation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety of our country and those who are serving as military, first responders, medical, and essential personnel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, may they soon be brought to eternal peace with the Lord in heaven, especially Malcolm Legay III, Christian Warriors, members of our Mass Intention Guild, and all of our beloved deceased. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Arthur and Gertrude Butler, for whom our sanctuary candle is lit this week, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those needs best spoken in the silence of our hearts. For those needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Peggy Ferry, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we ask you to receive these prayers, for they are offered in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Today's second collection will be offered for clergy trust. Many of you probably don't know what clergy trust is, but you probably have wondered at times, what do priests do when they get old? They don't have children, they don't, you know, if they're, you know, blessed, they may have siblings who can take care of them in their older years. But clergy trust is the way in which the Archdiocese of Boston provides for its elder priests. We, of course, you know, need care in our older years, and so we look for our parishioners to help support those who have spent many years of service as priests. So today's second collection will be offered for clergy trust. At the back of the church, we also have envelopes, which you can use to send your donation to the Archdiocese of Boston. There's also a QR code on there that you can scan with your phone if you'd like to make that donation online. We, of course, and I personally, thank you very much for your generosity in supporting our priests.
Our offertory hymn is The Summons, number 210.
Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown?
distract or scare? Will you let me answer prayer in you and you in me? Will you let the blinded see if I but call your name? Will you set the prisoners free and never be the same? Will you kiss the leper clean and do such as this unseen and admit to what I mean in you and you in me?
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy,
most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, in paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers and all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body,
which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father, in faith, in the offering of your high priest, Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us, who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from sin. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 458, Shepherd Me, O God, number 458. Communion hymn is number 437, On Eagle's Wings, number 437.
And he will raise you up on.
Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord. Please join us for our annual parish picnic beginning today at noon. So I hope to see you back here just in a couple hours. Next weekend, we will have the blessing of the backpacks during the 9 a.m. Mass. Our book club is still reading Bride's Head Revisited, and the next meeting is on September 30th. Our annual Christmas fair will be held the weekend of November 6th and 7th. Signups for theme baskets will be next weekend after all of the Masses. And lastly, we are looking for Eucharistic ministers and lectors and ushers. A typical time commitment for those volunteer opportunities is about once a month. If you are interested, please complete the forms that are in each and every one of your pews. And you can just leave these in the box at the back of the church, or you can email me for more information. And lastly, all current ushers are kindly asked to email me for upcoming training. This will be required for ushers who wish to continue to serve. We do have certain requirements that the Archdiocese of Boston asks our ushers to fulfill, so we want to make sure that we're doing everything we can to follow the guidelines of the Archdiocese. So we have these upcoming trainings. So please do email me, ushers. Do ask that you do that. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God Heart of Jesus. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Please join us in our closing hymn, number 728, Lead Me, Lord, number 728.